They will be playing Jurassic World while eating chips. We got a new dinosaur.
On the night of June 10th, Terry met with Norwood in a parking lot. And Norwood anally raped against the car. It was extremely painful.
Not fair.
That rape, I think, was a catalyst.
But it's only level 10.
Has been bottled up his entire life. The question in Terry's case is,
you know what, let's do a battle.
To execute Terry Williams for murdering a man who raped him repeatedly from the age of 13, including a violent rape the night before the homicide.
No, I chose something good.
In front of the Pennsylvania Parole Board. We started going after some of the charts.
Oh, Mom. Little bird can't fit me.
When I testified before the clemency board, I made up the name Tammy Williams. If this case was about a girl,
when
sexual abuse the Terrians, would we not see her as a victim of a succession of predatory men?
But the state argued Terry was a vicious murderer who deserved to die.
Oh, and I won.
This was an extraordinarily brutal murder, and more than that, it was not his first crime. He had murdered a different man named Herbert Hamilton a few months before.
At the time Mark Draper gave Terry up for the Norwood murder, he also named him for the unsolved killing of 50-year-old Herbert Hamilton, a supporter of local youth sports.
Hamilton was a classic predator. He bought gear for the team, so he was viewed as this nice guy who's doing good things. But it was a pretty thin veneer, because he was an intimidating, threatening individual.
According to Terry, he was when Hamilton pressured him into sex for money. One night, an encounter escalated.
He asked Terry to pose for nude photographs, and when Terry refused, it moved very quickly to threats. It erupted into a violent fight between Terry and Hamilton. And Terry killed the perpetrator.
Terry faced trial for Hamilton's murder a year before Norwood, and claimed self-defense. The prosecutor, Andrea Falks, painted Terry as a prostitute who murdered his son.
The argument that Terry Williams chose to prostitute himself is absurd. Hamilton owned Terry like all the other predators in Terry's life. This didn't just happen once. This happened over and over and over again, and it happened to a child.
Terry was found guilty of third-degree murder in the Hamilton case, carrying a sentence of up to 27 years.
When there was more evidence of a sexual relationship, the prosecution was perfectly willing to provide evidence of motive. But in the Norwood case, there wasn't any evidence. Terrence Williams has every incentive to make something up. He's literally trying to save his skin.
The clemency board voted 3-2 in favor of mercy for Terry, but a unanimous vote was required for the governor to act. With Terry Williams' execution just 2 weeks away, new evidence would now come to light.
The prosecution has said all of the things that we were saying about Mr. Norwood were based on hearsay. That's not really the case, because the evidence was in their own files the entire time.
What's different about life? It's the only chemically proven absorption. So the good stuff really sticks, and they're irresistibly tasty too. America's number one baby vitamin brand. It might be better.
When you think of a bank, you think of people in a place. But when you have the Chase mobile app, your bank can be virtually anywhere.
Nismo.
And you can check your balance from here. You can save for an emergency from here. Or pay bills from here. So if someone asks you, who's your bank? You can tell them, here's my bank. Or here's my bank. Or here's my bank. Because if you download and use the Chase mobile app, your bank is virtually any place. Visit chase.com/mobile.
The ancient Greeks had four words for love. The most admirable is called
I'm not to afford it. Wait.
At Sprint,
employees and communities safe. During these uncertain times, we want you to get great service without leaving the safety of your home. Shop at Sprint.com for free next day shipping and no activation fees on our best new phone deals, like a Samsung Galaxy phone for just $0 a month. Plus, you'll also get a $100 prepaid MasterCard when you switch online. Stay healthy and visit Sprint.com to get the services you need.
My ultimate goal for my condition is to not have to think about it. Roman allows me to do that. It made the process so much more personalized and expedited. It doesn't have to be so difficult to find the care and medication that you need.
What can you do in 30 days?
At National University, we think a lot.
That's why for over 20 years we've offered 4 week classes online.
I remember sending out ShipStation. I think it was just like one or two clicks. Everything was up and running. Us printing out labels and saving money.
ShipStation saves us so much time. It makes it really easy and seamless. Pick an order, print everything you need, stock the label in the box, and it's ready to go.
Our costs for shipping like were cut in half, just like that.
ShipStation, the number one choice of online sellers. Go to ShipStation.com/TV and get 2 months free.
Your favorite things are made for you. Your education should be too. University of Maryland Global Campus was founded more than 70 years ago to serve working adults and the military. As pioneers of digital learning, we offer rolling admissions, online courses, and no-cost digital course materials. Earn your degree from an affordable, respected state university that's made for you. No application fee if you apply by May 31st at umgc.edu.
Our science had evolved, and it was fair to take a new look at this evidence.
Death Row Stories, Sunday at 9 p.m.
Closed captioning is brought to you by the original Duct Tape brand, Duct Tape.
Just like you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's very different now. Time to do another battle.
Mr. Draco testified that he knew that Terry had been in a relationship with Mr. Norwood, and that he was encouraged by the prosecution and the police not to talk about this as a sexual encounter or anything like that. So the judge decided she wanted to see what was in this police file.
Judge Sarmina ordered all files to be handed over to the court. Terry's defense team would finally see the evidence they've been fighting to uncover.
That's an Argentinosaurus, guys, if you didn't know.
There was a group of prosecutors.
Crocodile dude.
this statement was sanitized, and it really was.
In the files,
no block. Oh, that was a good choice. And we have a winner. I freaking won that. So we got 120 DNA. This is awesome. Reach level 5. I'm so close to level 5. And another bunch of money worth. More benefits for being a member. That's just garbage.
What's important is that the record is clear. That's all I can say.
The evidence the prosecution didn't turn over were a couple of notes about what people had said about Amos Norwood, this kind of gossip. That's not evidence of a sexual relationship.
I'm episode 5, I can get it now. Where's the Argentinosaurus? Okay, how's that? Their journalist is here to review the park. Are we ready? Already, I'm ready.
Investing, banking, guidance.
Respond to the like.
PetSmart has everything your pet needs.
feeds delivered directly to your door. Or save 10% when you buy online and pick up in store. Now with curbside pickup. Shop PetSmart.com or download our mobile app today.
At Domino's, we pride ourselves on handcrafted pizza. But after leaving our 450-degree ovens, the only hands that touch them are yours. Mix and match any two or more for just $5.99 each and get them with contactless delivery from Domino's.
We're at the movies and we need to silence our phone. Who knows where that button is?
I don't have silence.
Everyone that's right up here.
It happens to all of us. We buy a new home and we turn it
money maker.
What I do is help new homeowners overcome this.
Is that adjustable span or good choice, Steve?
Don't forget, you're not assisting again. You hire them. You have nowhere to sit. You're too many. Who else reads books about some things?
My dad.
Yeah.
Oh, those are. Hug and you stupid.
Want to know what pros everywhere are excited about? This, the Centipede Portable Workbench. It brings a whole new inspiration to pro work days. Centipede Portable Workbench lets you stage a completely customized workspace in seconds. But able to support 3,500 pounds. It's the only game-changing workbench that was made to meet the demands of the pro. You might expect to pay $500 or more for any pro workbench. Through this exclusive TV offer, you won't pay $500, $400, or even $300. Order our most popular 9-strut centipede today and pay only $129.95 plus shipping and handling. With your order, we'll include our storage bag, X cups, quick clamps, and clamp edge saw guide. Plus, every centipede comes with a lifetime warranty. Hurry, supplies are limited, and this tremendous value won't last long. Visit boriscentipede.com today.
On October 3rd, 2012, Terry Williams' execution was 2 hours away when the court's decision came down.
I got a call at about 4:30 from a reporter in Philadelphia who said to me, I just got word that the Pennsylvania Supreme Court is going to leave the stay in place. That's how we found out. I found out from a reporter.
I just got on the floor
and
started praying. You know, I was talking to God.
The Pennsylvania Supreme Court temporarily stayed Terry's execution in order to fully review Judge Sarmina's decision, a process led by Chief Justice Ron Castile. But Castile had also been the district attorney at the time of Terry's original trial.
One of the first things we found when we were allowed to go through the district attorney's files was a memo personally signed by Ron Castile saying, I hereby authorize you to seek death. So we filed a motion for his recusal.
Castile personally denied the motion for his recusal and 2 years later presided over the court's unanimous decision.
In December of 2014, the Pennsylvania Supreme Court overturned Judge Sarmina's decision. Terry was back at
looking. Freaking ads, go away.
Take this issue up to the United States Supreme Court. And then in October of 2015, they accepted the case.
8 months later, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled on Terry's case. Justice Anthony Kennedy announced their decision.
Whether to ask a jury to end the defendant's life is one of the most serious discretionary decisions a prosecutor can be called.
Go on, ads. I don't care if you're trying to kill flies. And get chicken pox. Just kidding.
In December 2017, Terry appeared before Judge Sarmina to learn what his new sentence would be.
I'm gonna need a cow.
Orders, and Terry read a statement that he had prepared that was filled with remorse.
I destroyed my life, and I destroyed other people's lives who were part of my family and the victim's family.
Rome. Got a car.
At age 51, after 31 years on death row, Terry Williams began serving without parole for the murder of Amos Norwood. Sean Nolan and his team continue to fight for a new trial.
Really,
the level of his conduct for many, many years. And, you know, the fact that Terry's now something that needs to be re-examined, I think.
Nope.
For me, it's okay that Terry Williams...
Love you, Mom.
A
I'm playing my favorite game, Nyrex.
Death sentence defendants into martyrs.
Next mission.
There's so much I say to being on death row and not really believing I was going to get another chance at life. And when it happened, just opened up new possibilities for me, not only for redemption, but to become the man that I want to become. I want to make the best that I can of the life that I have left.
We see in Terry's case such a profound example of you brutalize and torment a child, and there's only so long that that child can contain it. And hopefully, you know, prosecutors, defense attorneys, everybody involved in the criminal justice system will look at how this case sort of ran its course and say, well, let's do better. Let's not let this happen again.
You dang truck, get over here.
When she was a young girl, very outgoing, spontaneous.
Run away.
That's why she made such a good flight attendant.
Nope.
During one of her out-of-town trips, an airline employee
marked
Ludwig with some bad news.
It was some woman explained to me that there had been a problem in Detroit and I should get myself ready to get out the airport. And they would meet me there if we could fly to Detroit.
Nancy Ludwig was found dead in her hotel room near the Detroit airport. She had been stabbed to death.
How am I supposed to defeat a dumpster, a freaking truck?
She had such extreme defense wounds on her hands. You just couldn't help by getting a real feel for what she went through, and that isn't really always the case at a crime scene.
Nancy's hands had been bound with twine.
This particular kind of twine
London Rex
most frequently used in gardening and landscaping.
Biological evidence revealed that Nancy had been sexually assaulted, and there were signs the killer spent a considerable amount of time inside the hotel room.
We found a bloody washcloth by the basin, and we could see that he had showered in the tub. He could not have walked out of the Hilton Hotel in bloody clothing.
One of the most unusual aspects of the crime was that Nancy's personal belongings were missing.
She arrived at the hotel with at least two suitcases and a purse. All of her jewelry, her watch, earrings were all removed from the room.
including the trash can, from the trash can.
On the night of the murder, another guest at the hotel noticed a man carrying airline-type luggage to his car.
Right outside his window, underneath the parking lot light, was what appeared to be Monte Carlo, with somebody carrying toward an open trunk what looked to be Northwest gear, suitcases, and whatnot.
Nope.
There were 2,800 Monte Carlo automobiles registered in the Detroit area.
Every one was 2,800 owners. We ran lean to determine whether there were warrants or whether they had criminal records, and tried to eliminate it that way.
Investigators learned that a hotel employee's boyfriend owned a Monte Carlo. When questioned, the employee behaved suspiciously.
She was caught in a lie. She claimed that a call had come in to Nancy's room. She claimed to have known Nancy from previous trips. Actually, it was Nancy's first trip into Metro, surprisingly enough. So she couldn't possibly have known her from a previous trip. There were no calls into her room.
What's with all the dang ads?
The way they assigned rooms to flight people, it was often done with keys just sitting there at the desk, with names on little pieces of paper. So you could come in and stand there and read names of rooms that had been assigned, so you knew who hadn't come in yet. I mean, it's an absolute terrible system.
Outside doors were left open at night. It was more convenient for the guests, but the server wasn't good security.
Mexico Rex.
Come on. We ultimately had a list of over 22,000 names. Members were 1,700 tips. People who flew into Metro Airport the night that Nancy Ludwig did. People who flew out after Nancy Ludwig was killed. The 2,800 Monte Carlos.
A police artist developed this sketch of the man in the hotel's parking lot. Investigators hoped it would narrow the list of 22,000 names to one.
It's best we stay apart for a bit, but that doesn't mean you're in this alone. We're automatically refunding our customers a portion of their personal auto premiums. We're also offering flexible payment options for those who have been financially affected by the crisis. We look forward to returning to something that feels a little closer to life as we knew it. But until then, you can see how we're here to help at libertymutual.com/COVID-19.
Great.